We shall see if my voice continues to work. And we thank God for the blessings he has brought to me this day, and hopefully you folks. As Rich has already stated, there's something special and joyful about children, and more especially on a day such as this, when we remember the Christ child and get to hear brand new babies crying. Let them cry. It doesn't bother me one bit. Testimony of St. John, verse 13. First chapter, verse 13. He was born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the same word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. The glory as of the only begotten of Father, full of grace and truth. John bare witness of him and cried, saying, This is he of whom I spake. He who cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. For in the beginning was the Word, even the Son, who is made flesh and sent to us by the will of the Father. And as many as believe on his name shall receive of his fullness. And of his fullness have all we received, immortality and eternal life through his grace. Amen. I noticed that Kathy wasn't in the group today. I hope you didn't dismiss her. Is she sick? What'd you do to her, David? I and my wife have both been very sick. I shouldn't even mention this. But her fever broke. We both had an upper respiratory infection. I think a wonderful son-in-law of mine must have given this to us. And I called Rich Tuesday, Wednesday. I said, I'm not going to be able to preach. You're going to have to fill in for me. He says, just hang in there. You'll get better. And my fever broke quicker than Mary Sue's. But the throat isn't coming back, so you're really blessed. And I'm not going to talk that long. I thought I was going to have a little more music in this, Marla. Where'd she go? It's been wonderful, just fantastic. Watched all those children come up here. It's just amazing to see all of that and know what we have in this congregation. And then when we sat here, I heard a couple of new babies crying, and I'm sure there shall be more. One thing about it is we're prolific. Now back to the song. My wife told me that on a Wednesday night, when I was ill with the other thing on my shoulder, and didn't come to prayer meeting, that's my excuse, Rich gave a little biblical dissertation on Mary and her journey. And she said it was just wonderful. And so we're grateful for that, and I got to hear the whole thing, Rich. That's the way Mom is. And so I wanted a particular song sang, and the girl sang this song, and it just is so fantastic. And take a moment and close your eyes and think about the fact that a young woman married and had a baby before marriage, I guess, or pregnancy, and traveled through the night miles to go to the place where the baby would be born. And the breath of heaven came down over her and picked her up. And she knew, saints, she absolutely knew it was not hers. That's not actually so, but it's not Joseph and hers. But she knew that it was the Son of God. And she went to have the baby and bring to the world the best gift of Christmas any of us could ever get. And there's so much more to that story. Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me. If we get one thing out of all this wonderful music, out of all these beautiful children, out of anything I might say, which won't be long, may we ourselves be held together throughout our lives by the wonderful breath of heaven. There's a song that we've been playing a lot. There's a lot more than that song, but for Christmas time, that's about all I've done all week long is listen to music and read the scriptures and reread the scriptures and think about the story of Christmas. And we recognize that we celebrate this time of Christmas. It's great times. It brings joy to the family. It brings gifts to our lives. It brings the pleasures of the family. I think my girls are a little bit sad that they don't get to hide or find out where I've hidden that extra gift for them and my son, because they still want to look around and they're a little old to get that grant from Daddy anymore. But anyway, it's such a joy this time of year. And so we celebrate the birth of Christ, but we're remembering the event. Please keep that in mind. We're not going to be worried about a date or when or whatever it was. We're remembering the event that took place. So we celebrate the birth of Christ. And I wanted to point that out because when I grew up in a home, my parents had some association with the Methodist and the Baptist Church. I don't know that either one of them ever went to church, hardly any. And we certainly didn't hear Christ mentioned in our house at all. Not that he wasn't mentioned, we just didn't do it. So, we're remembering the event that occurred, not necessarily where it occurred or when it occurred, and that's what it's about. The song I mentioned that I like to hear is sung by Anne Murray. She has three Christmas wishes, and if you know the scriptures I've read so far and what I'm going to read at the end, those wishes were for peace on earth and for goodwill in the lives of all men and for love in all we do, not just now, but forever and everlasting. That's a very beautiful song that she sings, and of course she's not in vogue anymore. So we celebrate and remember the event. Christ is our greatest gift, the gift of salvation to us. God sent us a son, his son, a baby. How many of you were born a baby? How many of you weren't born a baby? How many of you had a miraculous birth? You know, that's kind of a smiling thing. I had a friend and her husband, and they had a baby, and she was an old woman. What was she, Mom? 53 or 4. I won't say what that's close to. And she just almost had a nervous breakdown. Seriously. You know who was the closest, best, most wonderful person in their life in their old age? The last born child. Thank God for wonderful children. Now to the event. He's our greatest gift and the gift of salvation to us. And he came to us as that baby. And we celebrate Christmas for that reason and that reason only. Seriously. All else pales. It's going to hear me breathing too hard. When it comes to that, everything else about Christmas pales. John in the first verse said he brought to us, first chapter, immortality and eternal life. Verse 14, he said, the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And there's a song that I sang for many years back when I could sing. I'm not going to sing it, but it goes a little like this. He left the splendor of heaven. Think about this, saints. He left the splendor of heaven, knowing his destiny was to be the lonely hill of Golgotha. Remember who stood at the foot of that cross? In great sadness, but in great celebration. And I want to cry. Mary, his mama. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and so it is. Christmas is a time of loving and enjoying pleasures. It's a time for children and adults. I could name a few adults in here who just love to give their grandchildren gifts. So we try as a family to celebrate the joy of Christmas. But we don't neglect and leave out the Christ of Christmas. As parents of these children, if you're like I am, or more so my wife is, we have worked diligently with loving and caring, nurturing and building of these children to let them become what we want them to become. Hopefully, none might run astray, but occasionally it happens. And so we encourage them and we teach them the things of life. But most importantly, we teach them the story of Mary and Jesus and Joseph's family. I turned the TV on very briefly this morning and caught Billy Graham and his son talking after a bunch of youth sang some songs, kind of like we had today. And they spoke of the fact that we have, and I don't think any of you would dispute this, have kind of left Christ out of Christmas. We never want that to happen in our lives. And I know there are families in this congregation who faithfully read the Christmas story to all of their children. Praise God for them. Even if you don't read it all, read parts of it, bits and pieces, encouraging them and strengthening them. Jesus was in the beginning as a baby such as us. He was received as a baby. At the tender young age of 12, he went to the temple and confounded and disturbed the big shots of the temple. How could he do that? He was the Son of God, the one and only Christ child. Keep Christ in your Christmas. He brought to us life eternally. Our Savior, not of man, to save heaven and earth. And that's what it's all about. To save us from our sins by the deed which he did for us on that hill of Golgotha. Turn with me to the chapter 6 of John. I never do this, but somebody brought me some water. Verses 38 through 42. I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him that sent me. And this is the Father's will which hath sent me, that of all which he hath given me, I should lose nothing, but should raise it up again at the last day. And this is the will of him that sent me, that everyone which seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up in the resurrection of the just in the last day. And we know that came to be when he arose. Rising was our privilege and responsibility to reach that point. Then the folks that knew him, those wonderful Jews, they murmured and griped because he said, I am the bread which came down from heaven. And they said, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How is it then that he saith, I came down from heaven? Jesus therefore answered and said unto them, murmur not among yourselves. Sacrifice and nothing else is what it's all about with Christ. Life and truth through him eternally. There's another song we sing in the hymnal I want to just touch briefly on. And we sing it. We didn't need it today because we've heard it in these songs already. I stand amazed in the presence. Think about that. I stand amazed in the presence of Christ our Savior. He lives. He lives. He lives. When we accept that fact and let him become a part of our lives, we will never be the same. We should never be the same again. Then drop down to that same chapter, John 6. John 6:47-51. We're going to have a grand feast Christmas Day. Oh, we're going to pig out. Some of you might eat ham, turkey, chicken, beef. Whatever we can afford, we can have it. We got one turkey in our house split amongst 1,000 people. That's an exaggeration, but seemed awful big to me. In a house that was, I'm just putting it in perspective for all of you, a house that was probably maybe 36 foot wide, perhaps 38, and not much longer than that. And we had a pretty large family. So we know what it was like to have a feast, because no matter what we didn't have, Mama was a cook and we gorged on it. Now let's read this about feasting at Christmas, the rest of that part of John. Verily I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath everlasting life. I am the bread of life. Anyone who's had sacrament in the church has partaken of the bread of life. I am the bread of life. This is the bread which cometh down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. Praise God. Your fathers did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. But I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. That's what Christmas feasting is about. Feasting on Christ and the life he lived for us and the life he gives to us forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I will give for the life of the world. And you turn the over page and you've heard it many times having to do with this sacrament. May God bless you this Christmas. Don't pass out, but I'm finished. God bless you and enjoy life. And enjoy it in the physical and spiritual presence of Christ, your beloved Savior. Amen.